Welcome to another Haas tip of the day. Now, in machining, very few things are as practical as finding the edge of a part, touching off a tool, or picking up a hole. That's why in this tip of the day, we're going to be manually picking up a hole using all kinds of different indicators. Okay, so here's our part. Now, when I set my G54 work offset on the back left corner of this square stock, right, I just use an edge finder or my indicator. Now, we made an entire other video showing you how to pick up an edge. So if you need to learn how to do that, watch that other video. What we're doing right now is picking up a hole. This part is really abstract. There's not a straight line on it. It's nothing but curves. So I took one of these holes and I drilled clean through it in the first operation. So when we put this into our jaws for the second op, all we've got to do now is pick up that hole and set that as our G55. Okay, so to pick up this hole, I'm going to go ahead and grab one of these indicators, and I choose this guy. This is a nice vertical indicator with an axial support. Basically, the principles for picking up this hole with this indicator can be followed for using all these other indicators. If you can follow what I'm doing right now, you'll be able to pick up any hole with any indicator. Now I'm gonna jog somewhere above the part. Before I get too close, I'm gonna stop and I'm gonna rotate this indicator by hand. And what I wanna do is tap my indicator about until the ball at the tip of my indicator looks like it's not moving. Now, if this takes a little bit of time, it's time well spent. So I've eyeballed this thing pretty good. Now I'm gonna jog my indicator down above the top of that hole. And I'm going to get it pretty close in both the X and the Y. I'm going to go ahead and put it on one thou increment, 0.001, and see how close I can eyeball this to the center of this hole. It's a good idea to take your time with this. Make sure that you're pretty well centered on that hole before we drop in and start indicating. Now, this is really important here. When I grab this hand wheel, I always move a few clicks in the clockwise direction rather than just grabbing the wheel and going Z negative. And there's a reason for this. If you didn't press the right increment, if you were on 0.1 increment instead of 0.01, if you didn't hit the right button or you're on the wrong axis and you move down, you could drive that indicator right into your part. So try getting in the habit of moving clockwise a few clicks first. So if the machine happens to lunge, at least your indicator didn't get crushed. Okay, so I'm gonna move up, we're in the right increment, and now I'm gonna jog down into the hole, maybe an eighth of an inch, about 0.1, 0.2 inches. Once there, I'm gonna grab my indicator and I'm gonna pull it towards myself so that it makes contact with the sidewall of the hole, somewhere near the middle of the indicator's travel range. Now, some indicator mounts have little adjustable thumb wheels that make this part of the process really easy. Now that I've made contact, I'm going to rotate this until my indicator is following my x-axis. Once there, I'm going to zero out my indicator. Now I'm going to rotate my indicator 180 degrees and see what my numbers are. It looks like I'm off by about 10 thou. So what I want to do is split the difference. I'm going to jog about 5 thousandths of an inch to the right, and then I'm going to go ahead and re-zero my indicator. Now I'm going to keep doing this. I'm going to keep going back and forth along the x-axis only until my indicator needle reads zero, facing both ways, both to the right and to the left. Now rotate the indicator so it faces you. We are now measuring along the y-axis. Jog the y-axis on the smallest increment possible, 0.0001, until the dial reads zero, matching your x-axis readings. Now we're going to repeat this whole process over again. We're going to check the x's, make sure they're even, and then we're going to move the y-axis until it reads the same as your x-axis did. We're pretty much done. I'm going to rotate this around to see what the backside looks like in the y-axis. It looks like we're done. I can rotate the indicator all the way around and see that the needle is staying right there at zero. We've found the center of our hole. The center line of our spindle is now directly above the center of our hole. At this point, don't touch anything. We're going to go to the work offset page, and I'm going to go to G55. I'm going to press part zero set to set my x-axis location, and part zero set again to set my y-axis location. Okay, we're done. Let's go ahead and pull out this indicator, and we'll just start explaining some of these other indicators that we could have used to do the same thing. Well, a real common tool that we all use, right, is a magnetic base with an indicator. Now, if you're using a mag base, we're not going to be mounting it to the outside of the spindle, right? We're going to put it onto the part of the spindle that actually rotates round and round. Now, the nice thing about this style of mag base is that they come in all different shapes and sizes, right? Depending on what kind of part you need to measure. Next is our Indicol. What's unique about this indicator setup is that it'll go on most Cat 40 tool holders. It just kind of snaps along the outside edge. It's like an erector set, all the pieces you can add to it. With extensions, this is a great accessory to help you reach large diameter parts. Next on our list is this dovetail mount using a horizontal indicator. Now, for a lot of years, this was my favorite indicator setup. It was cheap, fit in a small little box. I could use this indicator for everything. I gotta tell you, the one drawback of this indicator is that as you're rotating the part round and round, you can't see the dial as the indicator is facing away from you. Now, you can use a mirror. We've all done that. And a little side tip here, if you're using a mirror and you need an extra hand, grab your micrometer stand and use that to hold your mirror for you. Or you could even use a magnetic base to hold the mirror. Okay, so this indicator I really like lately. This is a 3D sensor. You can use this as an edge finder as well. Picks up things remarkably quickly, right, manually. You can also use this for picking up holes. You can find one edge, then the other, and split the difference. Well, we're going to finish up here on our coaxial indicators. These are the gold standards for picking up holes, and there's a good reason for that. The dial is always facing the operator. With the coaxial indicators, you can use a mag base to hold the arm on the blade coaxial indicator to keep it from spinning around on you. And the Heimer actually has a built-in kind of antenna that can rest against your part to your fixture to keep the face from spinning while you indicate. Well, we did it. We were able to pick up the hole on our part and set our G55 X0Y0 offset. Now, normally to pick up a hole, I would have just used a probe, right? The probe could have given us the diameter of that hole as well, and we could have done all kinds of fun stuff with that value. Well, if you like this video, be sure to like, share, comment, and subscribe. You don't want to miss any of these upcoming videos. Well, thanks for letting us be a part of your success and for watching this Haas Tip of the Day. Thank you.